Hello, and welcome to episode 1 of Let's Play Civilization 6. We're starting a new series today. We will be playing as Rome. This will be our first playthrough on the new fall patch. I don't know when this is going to go up, this series, I mean. I might start posting it maybe early winter in December sometime, but it's late November right now, and the patch has just come out. It's supporting DirectX 12, which I am running it under, and there are some patches to the game which improved some AI performance issues. A lot of UI bugs were fixed, so it's going to play a little bit differently. This will be my first full game post-patch. I did play one game as Rome after my last Japanese game on Immortal Difficulty, so this will be the game following that game. I just wanted to see how Rome plays before I do a Let's Play, because it's also nice to take a break from recording as well. So let's go ahead and start that. We'll keep most of the same settings as before, except we'll be changing the Civ to Rome this time. Okay, single player, create game. Immortal again. Standard speed, continents, is fine. And we will stick to large. And let's go ahead and do that. Oh, forgot to change the leader, important thing. So Rome gets a legion, which is a strong swordsman replacement, and the bath, which is a aqueduct replacement. More happiness and more... more housing as well, and more happiness. So our city should grow larger without an extra neighborhood district, or a lot of extra districts that would generally give us housing. So it's good. And it also has this thing, all roads lead to Rome, which gives us extra gold for trade routes passing through our cities. All our city starts with a trading post, which means we can do internal trade routes a lot better, and extended range of our trade route a lot further as well. And the most important part here is all the cities in trading route range that I build will automatically get a road to Rome, my capital city. So this is huge. It makes expanding a little bit easier early on. One thing that this Rome won't have, obviously, is Japan's adjacency bonuses. So the great super industrial production cities that I had in my last game as Japan won't be as available this time around. It's going to be much more normal late gameplay, but I was able to overcome it in my last game as Rome, not recorded, so I'll see if I can do that again this time. So my record now is 3-4-5 on Immortal Difficulty. 3 games out of 5.
From the first stirrings of life beneath water, to the great beasts of the Stone Age, to man taking his first upright steps, you now begins your greatest quest. From this early cradle of civilization on towards the stars. Cast your net wide, O Trajan, Emperor of mighty Rome. Your legions stand at the ready to march out and establish the largest empire the world has ever seen. If you can truly get all roads to lead to Rome, yours will be an empire of great riches and luxuries. Surely then our citizens will proclaim you as their best ruler, the Optimus Princeps.
Right, one of the things that changed with the patch is each time I load up the game, this beginning text will change depending on my era. So I'm starting from the very beginning, so I get the normal text, but as I progress through the classical, the industrial, the modern, the atomic, and the information era, this text changes each time, which I'll see if I can show it to you in different episodes, but that's an interesting feature. And again, this is the first time we were getting Trajan as a Roman ruler. We've usually gotten Caesar, or Augustus, in I think Civ 4 and 5. Okay, let's begin. Jungles. Okay. Well, for starters, jungle starts aren't so bad in Civ 6 compared to other games. I think I was talking about this in one of my Japan Let's Plays about in Civ 3, jungle starts tend to basically be a death sentence for a lot of play, or a challenge play, because it takes so long to remove the jungles. But in this game, it's not so bad because jungles give you, I think, production. Yeah, some production and quite decent amount of food. And you want to keep them around, especially if you're building science districts, if you don't have mountains. So I can see right off the bat we have a gypsum here and dyes, and a bunch of bananas, which will be a lot of good food for us later. So I'm just going to move this and have a peek. So there's a mountain here and another resource, probably too far for my city. One, no, actually my city can grab it if I don't build any other nearby cities, but this could be grabbed by another city. But I have three luxuries here, which isn't bad. So I'll build my starting city here. Okay, and let's see what continent we're on. Oh, so immediately there's two continents. There's Laurentia and Yuna. Interesting. Do we get the Eureka right away? I don't know. Let's start with pottery again. And begin with the slinger. They haven't fixed any of these yet, so the slinger is still usually more advantageous than scout to build right off the bat. I might build a scout or two later on. There we go. Yeah, we found the other continent, and there's a goody hut. Oh, another luxury and a pasture here for cattle, so that's good. Another luxury here, so this is a decent start.
No somos Felipe, rey de España y Portugal. Empero, por encima de todo, somos fieles devotos de la única y verdadera religión.
It's an honor to meet you. We would love to. Okay. So, it's close. I don't know what to think about this, but we'll think about it. Can I get here? I don't think I can get to the... Yeah, shoot. That sucks. Well, that's your coast right there. But I want to get to that. Oh! Whoa! That's interesting.
Enacting new policies in our government can be of great benefit.
At his best, man is the noblest of all animals.
Oh, the other thing I have as Trajan is I have Trajan's column. That's his specific ability, which means all of my cities start with a monument, usually, depending on which era you start. But usually I start at the ancient prehistoric era, so you start with a monument, which means early cultural production. Which means I get my code of laws a lot faster, and as I build my cities will all start with monuments, which means they automatically will expand their cultural borders without a lot of effort on my part, which is nice, because that's one less thing for me to build. And this ability does not expire, so it will go on all the way to the end game. And you can see here how quickly I got my policy right away. So we're going to do this. If you've watched my Let's Play, this has been my standard starting policies now for a few games. So we'll come back for this camp that the Spanish kindly left to us. So normally... tech boost. Okay, so normally We usually don't have a good history with a civ that starts so close to us. Or the first civ we meet. I'm thinking about the British in my last Japanese Let's Play. And the Sumerians in my Let's Play before that, where I lost. So we'll see how things develop with the Spanish. They did not... Oh, okay, they dislike us now. So I was going to say they didn't dislike us right off the bat, but I guess I spoke too early.
I thought Clay must feel happy.
You can see here how quickly we're earning social policies with that extra monument early on. It's a big difference. The AI can and will declare war almost immediately, so I have to be careful here, and that's why I'm building up with slingers instead of scouts.
That's the positive aspect of trade.
I'm gonna start research on that and then see if I can. There already. So there's another luxury. So what I'm doing here is I'm just seeing where else I can settle. I think a second city down here is good. I mean, Madrid is not gonna be happy, but if I can grab this, it's gonna be a nice river city. I'm gonna grab these two luxuries and this stone here. And then we'll expand further north. So I'm just seeing where I can go right now.
Welcome to the United States of America. If you conduct yourself well, you can consider us friends.
Okay. The US is up here.
Japan.
So the Japanese and the Americans have already sent delegations to me right away, which is good, but not the Spanish.
We have recently gained advanced knowledge.
Writing means sharing.
Oh, I should have done irrigation. I don't know why I did writing. Oh, I see a barbarian there. Let's swing back here. I'm looking for barbarians right now because those early Eurekas are important too. Oh, maybe they're not barbarians. Just the Spanish. Yeah, no barbarians there. So I expect maybe barbarians will be up here more, since this is such a crowded... Oh, no, right, never mind. Okay, I know where to go now. Okay. There's a scout. There's another camp up here, which good. Okay, it's not good. They found our encampment, so I'm gonna retreat here. the settler out right away. No city states nearby this game, which is gonna put a hamper on our one of our Eurekas, which is for our next government, the Classical Republic. Okay, I can see they did a UI thing where there's a little exclamation point, so the scout is getting ready to run back home to tell its... Oh, shoot. Can't do anything. So I'm gonna do this here. Can't do much here. Yeah, it's gonna run over there, I think, to tell the camp. Okay, rest them here. There's... Well, the barbarians are starting to attack, which is not good. Spanish clear out the camp down here? I thought I saw a camp here earlier. But in any case, there's a camp up here. There's some units we can kill for a Eureka bonus.
Without craftsmanship, inspiration is a mere reed shaken in the wind.
No. Oh, didn't mean to do that.
Thanks for keeping the peace on the continent. Bully for you!
So that's Teddy's agenda, is he likes people who do not declare war on his continent. And looks like we're sharing one continent with him, so that's fine. We'll finish this off to get our archer Eureka. Okay, where is that scout? That should, if I can kill this scout, I should get my next Eureka, which is killing three barbarians. And my Eureka after that is to clear a camp, which I need to do, but I need to rest up my units first. And then I need to continue my exploration, because that's kind of been put aside now, that with this early... this early war, I guess. I'm gonna move this slinger down here just to wait for instructions as my settler finishes up. And remember from last game, we're not too concerned about early empire here, because we should be able to get it with two cities adding up to a population of six, which is a nice thing that they did. It doesn't encourage people to not settle because they're trying to get that six pop city. So it's a nice... I mean, it's little things like that that you notice, that you can see that they've actually played the game and tested it.
The man who has grit enough to bring about the afforestation or the...
And tested it and probably received some feedback from other civ players and said, okay, this works, this doesn't work, this is good, that's not good. And you know, I've played games where they haven't done that kind of testing, and it shows. It's very telling when it's kind of like just the developers thinking, okay, this is how it should play, but they actually haven't played through it to realize that it doesn't work as well, or there's a problem with it, or anything like that. So okay, one turn left for a settler. I'm pretty sure we'll get a don't settle near us thing from Madrid as soon as I settle here, but that's too bad for them.
And mysticism is the mistake.
And I guess
my liege, We have an envoy at our disposal.
Okay, well, I can't do anything with that envoy right now, so that's going to stay, because we haven't met any city-states yet. So yeah, here's the thing, right? Let's see here. Let's do a scout. Get the builder out. So I should get that right away. I lost my train of thought, but I was saying, I guess I also kind of drive the diplomacy here. If I were to choose not to settle here and settle up here instead, maybe they'll like us more, but you kind of just have to... go with your gut here. And I think it's good to settle here. It's important for us to settle here. So we will settle here. And you'll see here, as soon as I settle my next city, I'm gonna get the a road directly linking it. So let's do the bananas. Oh no, no, no. Oh. Okay, the unit cycling is
our city-state neighbor.
Is still a bit of an issue here. I don't like it, because it will just move you to the next unit without the visual cues, and I've messed up. So let's put our envoy to Jakarta. That sucks. Delayed our settlement by one turn.
Reconnaissance unit.
Okay. And you'll see that I still have the new to Civ 6 thing on right now, because I feel like I need it for just to get a good idea of when things are available. Although I'm kind of getting a hang of it now. Oh, we got an early empire boost. And a wheel boost. That's a nice series of boosts that we got here. Nothing special about our terrain. And I usually tend to pick things that I can benefit from early on, rather than looking forward, because game like Civ tend to accumulate bonuses, right? So the more turns you have a bonus, the stronger it is. So if you're looking too far ahead for a bonus that you might get later on, let's say what's Goddess of the Sea, because these sea production units, these blowing sea resources, I'm going to get an extra production, but I might not settle here for another 15, 20, 30 turns, or even 50 turns, then those are 50 turns I'm not getting anything back from. So the most obvious one right here is I have 3 bananas here. There's more bananas here if I were to settle another city down here, is to go for this one, because I can get extra culture from bananas, citrus, which we do have down here, right? And there's one here too, but we're not going to get that. So that's an obvious place to go with this one. So we'll get extra culture, so that's what we'll get. Okay, next turn.
Who deserves more credit than the wife?
Okay, so we'll go for here and get that query up. Oh, it won't let me settle. Too close to the starting city, I think. Let's get the wheel going so we can get our... There's another camp here I can find, but I didn't get my 3 barbarian kills bonus, military tradition, I think. Or
bravery.
Oh,
is being
got that. Okay, so that's fine. Early empire, state workforce. Oh, I think I got that from a goody hut. So let's get early empire. No, let me leave that. I don't need that right away. This state workforce. And you can see here, automatically we have a road and we have a monument already. So big bonus. We need to find two more steady states to get our Eureka bonus. Not having much luck so far. Yeah. Apologies. Goodbye. Send this guy down here and work on one of these for early growth. Oh, I see a city state up here, I think. But we haven't been the first to meet them, so we're not getting the free envoy at start, which sucks. Yeah, we do have a few more military units than normal, but they're kind of spread out right now. And I shouldn't get complacent.
But as I headed into the heart of New Zealand's fjordland, that same childlike feeling, long lost, a pure, unadulterated awe, came rushing back. I knew the road to Milford Sound was good. But this good?
So provides one gold and one culture to adjacent tiles. Yeah, so these tiles are a lot better than normal. So I want to settle here, a city here, and that will be my coastal city as well. No luxuries though, but it's going to be a nice boost to us. We didn't get our early empire Eureka because I think we got it from the goody hut already, so maybe it's not working as... We can't finish a research like that. Can't get to Eureka's, I suppose. Once you get it, you get it. So I'm going to pull this slinger back because I'm getting worried that I'm sending him too far away. There's no defensive at home. There's Lisbon. Yep, we're not the first to meet them, so... What's Eureka for sailing. Train a galley, so they want us to build a coastal city, is basically what they're telling us here. Let's see here. We'll do this here. The barbarian camp. Send it to Kumai, or Madrid, or Jakarta. Let's do it to Madrid, just improve the relations. Yeah, so we get that Eureka as well. Okay, let's work on another settler here. Have a water mill to build after this.
A strong economy begins with a strong, well-educated workforce.
Early Empire, 4 turns left. There's a luxury here, so we won't be getting it if we build our city here, which is what I want to build, because yeah, the bonus tiles are all over here, though. Oh, I do get a luxury if I were to build. So I want to build one tile further up, which is further than I want it to be, but we'll get the wine. So all these tiles here get a bonus gold. So if I were to build here, I should be able to grab all these tiles, including the sea tiles. Okay. Oh, perfect. We met our third city state, Nanmadol. Continue.
Sometimes the wheel turns slowly.
Let's get masonry out. We'll get sailing soon. Okay. Put that in. Are we the first to meet them? No. America. I already have 3. I need to kill this last scout so I can get my bronze working. Ah, oh, what a pain. Have a look. I think this is just a coast here. 5 turns on settler. As expected, we're already getting reports of wonders. Oh, another camp and a barbarian camp there. Okay, so we should get our bronze working Eureka here. Okay, I'm gonna pull him back now. Why is he here? I don't have open borders with Focho. Did he settle close to us? Oh, there's Tokyo. So it's gonna be crowded down here. I don't like this. I think they're thinking about an early attack here.
It was luxuries like air conditioning that brought down the Roman Empire. With air conditioning, their windows were shut. They couldn't.
Oh, we got our Eureka for sailing without settling, so let me heal it up. No, I'll just do one more exploration here and then heal him up here. Okay. Let's do political philosophy. Okay. Okay, the Spaniards settled up here, which is weird. They're gonna be cut off. So we'll settle where we want to, which is on this side of the coast, and we'll deal with this side later. I can't handle all that right away. Okay. okay. They don't like our government. I don't know what they changed to. I'll check them on the diplomacy screen. Let's keep going here. Look at Hojo. You're an oligarchy. Well, we won't be going to oligarchy, unfortunately. Yeah, they don't like us already. Oh, they added the logo. Oh, nice. Hovering over them will tell you how many cities they have. They have 3 cities.
Your Grace, we have obtained
great. When wasteful war.
3 turns on that. Let's build a warrior first. I want to build a wall, but I think units are more important right now. Because all my units are far away. Pulling these guys back now.
Okay.
Not as prepared as I was, or I should be, on that. Oh shoot, I need to do that. Okay. Yeah, bad start here. Bad start, guys.
Opportunity.
Divide and rule.
Okay, let me choose my government first. We'll go Classical Republic. Oh, this is gonna be rough. Oof. Got too comfortable. We had a good start. Oh, I'm gonna lose Kumai. Build a slinger here. Okay, this is not a good start.
So interested in creating.
Je suis Catherine, reine mère de France. Je vous souhaite la bienvenue à mon royaume. J'ai grand désir et envie de découvrir tous vos secrets.
Thank you.
I don't believe in astrology.
Rome is saved. I almost lost Rome. Wow, what an amazingly terrible start. Worst timing ever. We want to take Kumai back. There's no way I'm going to lose this city here. Start our new trade route again.
The poets have been mysterious.
Thank you. Wow, Jesus. Really want the peace. And we're running longer than usual, I understand, but I want to finish this and then we'll pick up where we left off. But we're now significantly
Dovreste
behind.
Dovreste prestare attenzione a ciò che accade d'intorno. Credetemi, vi sono fin troppi giochini che stanno avendo luogo.
What an ordeal. All right, we'll make peace with the Japanese. Well, at least they're not willing to give us any of their cities. I'll take that. Gotta build a builder out here. Right, we didn't research pasture, which was our mistake, because then we didn't have archers. If we had archers, things would have gone a lot smoother. So anyways, this is a rough start for us. I'll see if we can recover from this. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next time.